How's it going, everyone? How you guys doing out there? Happy Thursday. Thanks for joining me here this evening. Another Thursday night. Woo! That's right. And I have a little studio audience with me here this evening. Say hi to everybody. Have a good time tonight, people. I hope you guys are ready to have a good time because we're going to take a little trip down memory lane this evening. All right, if you guys are with me on that. All right, let me get all set up here. So, yeah, hello. There we go. We're simulcasting this evening on Facebook and YouTube, so I had to just bring the channel up here and mute the feed so that I can hear, so we don't hear ourselves back and forth there. So what's going on? Steve is here. What's going on? Jim Curry, how you doing? Lexi's here. How you guys doing? Tina Barney, how you doing? Jay Carter, what's up, cuz? How you doing? Cindy DeGeorge is watching. Who else is here? Sharon Students is here. Mary Snover, what's going on? Chuck Broadway, all right. My brother Chuck, overseas, hanging out, watching. Steve is here, Lexi's here, Chris is here. Yeah, man, we're gonna have fun this evening, so I'm glad you guys are all here. Let's see if anybody has popped up. Okay, we got some people, we got some things happening on YouTube as well. Sharon Roberts is over there, Angie's there. All right, good deal. So thank you guys again for tuning in with me this evening here for another Facebook Live concert. So again, like I said, we're gonna have a good time tonight. I'm doing something a little different tonight, all right? As you guys have seen the announcement, I am, tonight is dedicated solely to the album Origins, which is a record that I put out in December of last year, and you know, as all musicians were hoping, I was hoping to be out touring this year and promoting it, but no.
So you got to promote it here.
We got the mandate, tonight. So we're doing it here.
From Florida.
So,
Hello, from Florida.
Right here, we're going to do it right here. But, so I wanted to give you guys a sample of what it might sound like with a band. So, I got the virtual band behind me. So basically what we're doing tonight is I'm going I have instrumental tracks of the record. So it's all of the instruments mixed and everything, minus the lead vocal track and a lot of the background harmonies. So that's what I'm gonna do in the music biz. We call that a TV mix. So so I'm gonna blow through a lot of the songs on the record and play along with my acoustic guitar and sing live for you guys. And, you know, just to give you an idea of what the record sounds like for those of you who don't have the record. So, this is going to be a lot of fun. This is something different than I've been doing. Usually it's just me with an acoustic guitar, which is fun. I love that intimacy. But this is almost going to be like a full band behind me tonight, so.
Live and concert. And an audience.
Or we should say it's going to be like mostly like Rex Schnelly behind me tonight. Because you guys have heard me talk about Rex.
He didn't sell
out. Rex was the mastermind, the genius musician behind a lot of the tracks on this record, all but two, actually. He played all of the instruments pretty much. And so it's like I have Rex with me here in multiple person. So yeah, man, we're gonna have a good time. So cheers to each and every one of you for coming and tuning in this evening.
Yep,
cheers for my studio audience here.
Cheers.
We're gonna have a good time.
Everybody get their jammies on and get a drink and hang out with us.
So we're gonna kick this puppy off right here with a little bit of baby's music for you. And don't forget, while you guys are watching this on Facebook, you can share this. And I was incorrect what I was saying before. You say you share it with all your friends. You can basically share it on your timeline, or you can pick a specific friend to share it with. Correct? Is that right? Sharing a live video.
I'm not sure. I think
it's something
on your
like
timeline
that.
Or to other Facebook
or to other
pages.
Sites. That's what it is. Other you can share it on your timeline. You can share this live concert on your timeline right now. And your friends will see it, may see it,
but
there's
other pop-up.
But then if you belong to other groups, you can share it on that page as well, like group pages. So, share away, people. All right, we're gonna do a song here off of Origins. The whole night's gonna be off Origins, believe that or not.
How many times are we gonna hear that?
See, yeah, right? And it's the old baby's tune called Back on My Feet Again. Here we go. All right. Studio musicians, are you ready? All right, let me get my volume mastered here. All right, here we go. Here we go. Back on my feet again. I was so lonely until I met you. Told myself I'd get by without love. Drowning my sorrows, avoiding tomorrow's, kind of felt that I just had enough. United my face with your jokes and your smile. The way that you gave me is a lie. Tell me what you got, but you sure that I found you. Could be wrong, but it sure feels right. So happy that you're here with me. So weird, I know you left me with nothing, but I guess it was just meant to be. Yeah.
was awesome.
Back on My Feet Again. What a great song by the Babies, man. Always loved that tune. Always loved it. What's going on out there? Let me check out Facebook and see what's going on. Jeff.
What?
Zelts in the house. Nashville. Watch from Nashville. All right, Donna says cheers. Cheers, Donna. Cheers. How you doing? Vinny is here. Okay, Rhode Island is watching. All right. I forgot to say, but these concerts are, they're always free. And, but I always put, a virtual tip jar up top there at the top of the feeds, both here and both on YouTube. Anything you guys feel like contributing, awesome. Very much appreciated. Not required. You know, if you feel like it, go for it. If not, sit back, relax, enjoy the show. But big shout out to Cleopatra for hitting that tip jar. Florida Freight Carriers of Apopka. Yeah, thank you. Dale Hilton and Linda and Phil Mollison and Linda Wheeler. Thank you for hitting the tip jar. Appreciate that, guys. Cheers. All right. So what shall we do next? James Lee is out on here.
Hi, Jamie.
Hi, Jamie.
Jamie's here.
Hey, Jamie.
Dieter from Germany is here. All right. Thanks for watching, man. You always tune in. Awesome. Donna's here. Good to see you guys. So let's keep this thing rolling here. All right. So next one we're going to do, this one's going to go out to my good buddy Eric. As he leaves to go to the bar.
Oh no,
he's changing seats. Sorry, sir. These seats tickets are non-transferable.
You're in the front row. What do you want?
Excuse me, sir. Can you return your seat, please?
Ask Bryce.
Text Bryce.
All right.
Gotta have an intercom down there.
Here we go. Love this tune. Love this band. You know, you cannot do a tenor record, a tenor vocal tribute record, without doing some triumph music, right? He's yes. Just one of those quintessential voices. So, track number two, I believe it is, on the record, is Magic Power by Triumph. You gotta have some Rick Emmett, baby. So here we go. And again, accompanied by the amazing Rick Schnelli on all of the instruments.
Did you hear it?
Here we go.
Hey, don't be stingy on the ice.
Don't be stingy.
Something's at the edge of your mind. You don't know what it is. Something you were hoping to find, and you're not sure what it is. Then you hear the music, and it all comes crystal clear. The music does the talking, who says the things you want to hear. Yeah, and I'm wild and I'm free. Forgot the magic power. Thank you. you just get started out? Do you want someone to tell you what they think it's all about? Are you hurting your little sanity? Reach out for the top. Well, music keeps you going, and it's never gonna stop. It's never gonna stop. It's never gonna, never gonna, never gonna, never gonna stop. I am now, I love now, I love to be free. Got the magic power. Such a great song. My God, such a great song.
Bringing back so many memories.
Yes. Are you guys enjoying this trip down memory lane? Because that is exactly what we're on, man. These are the songs that fired me up when I was a kid. I would hear the song and I go, that's awesome. I want to do that. And
you're doing it.
Here we are. I'm playing music on my phone right now. This is the world we live in right now, right? I can't wait to do this on a stage in front of you guys. So soon, it's coming soon. Some more people have hit that tip jar. Susie Rial, thank you. Michael Latanovich, Cindy DeGeorge, Carolyn Wheeler, and James Curry. Thank you guys so very much for that. Appreciate that.
Virtual cheers.
Cheers.
Virtual
cheers. Virtual cheers to each and every one of you guys. Has anybody got me on their big screen on the surround sound system or whatever? Take pictures, man. Post those. That's always fun. And as always, prerequisite, turn the news off. There is no news anymore. So let's see what's going on in YouTube. Check it out, man. Look at all the stuff going on YouTube. Hey, everybody. Amando, Tim Liberty. All right. Good to see you people. Rowdy Rocker.
Well, you really can't
there.
See them.
I'm on the chat. I'm on the top chat here. Yeah. That's what I'm seeing. That's all we can see right now is
names.
Chats. And then once the feed is over and then it's posted, then the comments start. But we're on the chat now. We're chatting. We're just chit-chat. Angie's here. Sharon Roberts. Good to see you, folks. Thanks so much for tuning in, man. Okay. Moving right along on the Origins song path here. We're gonna do some Rod Stewart music, all right?
Love you some Rod.
Because.
There you go.
I'm never gonna write that down,
you are
man.
Not.
And I said that when you guys were here that one night. You know, I said, you know, we're gonna do some Rod Stewart music because I love me some Rod, and I just walked right into that one, man. So I'm never gonna live that down. I'm gonna make a T-shirt. Love me some Rod.
Don't do that.
You better not.
You don't think I should do that?
Unless you're in
safety. I'm gonna think of some devil looks one. Did that shirt just say what I thought it said? All right, here we go. Some Maggie May for you. Again, always love this tune. This tune, I remember as a kid listening to this tune on the radio in the 70s. And it's just such a catchy melody, which is why I wanted to put it on this record. And I love this tune, so we're gonna just play it. Maggie May for you. Here we go, Rod Stewart.
Love you, Rod.
late September, I really should be back at school. I know I keep you amused, but I feel I'm being used. Oh, Maggie, I couldn't have tried anymore to let me away from.
Go-go dancer to go with it.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you could see the dancing that was just going on in here.
No. You don't want to see that dancing.
I have my camera's on back here, so it just showed that I'm going to post that.
No. Yeah.
Better put my pants back on.
Well, especially the Rod song.
Love me some Rod, man. Rod, Stitt. Rod, Stitt. Look at all the hearts here. That's awesome. You guys enjoyed that one. Good deal. Some more lovely people have hit that tip jar. Lisa Shipp, Lois Barbero, right? Barbero, yes. Lois Barbero.
I said it right.
Yay! Finally. Thank you guys for hitting that tip jar. Yeah, baby. So, origins. This really was a fun record to make. I mean, it really was. It was a big journey to knock down this big list of songs that I really would had ideas of loving to record, but narrow it down to like, you know, maybe 12 tracks. I ended up putting 14 tracks on here because I just couldn't help myself. But this was a fun record to do. It really was a trip down memory lane for me, really. And to really dive into these songs in the studio and with a microscope, it was, I have even that much more of an appreciation for these songs, so. I hope you guys do have the record, are enjoying the record, and playing it loud and pissing off your neighbors at the same time. For those of you who don't have a copy, it's still available. You can get digital downloads on my website, you can get a physical copy, and there's all kinds of other goodies on the website. Just go to jeffcoffey.com, that's C-O-F-F-E-Y.com, and you can see all that stuff. We even have masks.
Coffee filters.
See, hey, what, you don't like the name, man?
He does.
I kind of like chin diaper better. But
chin diaper, that's a good one, too. Chin diaper coffee filter. Right? Check it out, man, the Jeff Coffee, you know, coffee filter mask.
You have to model it.
Yeah, yes. So.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Just going to do the rest of the show like this. So far. You know, like when you're at the countertop and you're like, what? What? I can't understand the words that are coming out of your mouth.
Do some great Bob Dylan with that on.
Damn masks. But if you gotta wear a mask, might as well wear one in style, right?
You're right.
Alright. So another great singer that you just, you know, if you're gonna do a tenor rock album, you cannot bypass Mickey Thomas, man. Everybody remembers Mickey Thomas from Starship, you know, all those great hits. But not too many people remember the band that he was in when they first heard him sing this particular song, "Fooled Around and Fell in Love." I've even forgot the guy's name myself just now.
Elvin Bishop.
See, thank you. I need my information guru right here on my side. Elvin Bishop was a guitarist, and he had a band, and he had a singer named Mickey Thomas. This song comes out, bam! Everybody knows who Mickey Thomas is now. It's a great song, great vocal. It's like a bluesy rock tune that just lends itself a great vocal line, and he delivered so well, which is why I wanted to put it on this record. So, "Fooled Around and Fell in Love."
Here we go. Ready, man?
Ready, man.
Yeah. and on my own. It's the way it used to be since I met you, baby. Some people are doing out here. What's going on here?
Shirley said she's feeling all moosey inside. I'm not really sure what that means.
So Shirley said she's feeling all moosey.
Moosey.
Shirley, sweetheart.
Shirley Howard.
You gotta give me a definition of what moosey is, baby. Because I'm very curious to find out what moosey is.
Well, Myrna said, settle down, Shirley.
Myrna said, settle down, Shirley. Moosey. That's a new phrase for me. Moosey.
I think she meant to say mushy.
Mushy.
Oh.
Maybe? I'm feeling all moosey inside. Is that what mooseys feel like?
Chocolate
that?
Mushy.
Chocolate
mushy.
Mousse.
Chocolate mousse. I like chocolate mousse.
Moosey. That's going to be my next t-shirt. Love me some Rod makes me feel moosey. People are going to be going, what the hell is on that guy's t-shirt?
Little mask with you.
I have my Jeff coffee filter mask on. People are like, stay away from this guy. Tyson Leslie, good to see you, brother. Let's see, David Schmidt, hit that tip jar. Thank you so much, David. Appreciate that, man. All right. So, here we go. Tyson Leslie is a good musician friend of mine in Nashville. He says, first of all, he sounds spectacular as always. Thank you, brother. Hope your stream doesn't get shut down. My Fed was killed by Facebook last night, I suspect largely because I was using backing tracks like you are, so I'm going to track less. Yeah, that's interesting. Definitely, I don't know if you guys have heard, but we've all been watching it, the whole Facebook crackdown on what they call, quote unquote, a music listening experience. It's basically really cutting, it's trying to limit DJs from creating listening environments, like a Spotify playlist. DJs apparently had been coming on Facebook, doing lives, and just pushing play, like DJs do, and just playing music, other people's recorded music. And Facebook doesn't want it to be that. They want it to be an interactive thing. So that's what it is. But yes, my backing tracks are off my record. So I own all of the masters of this stuff. So this is all my stuff. Some of it's me, most of it's Rex Schinelli, and I paid for all of this. So yeah, though it's a valid concern, but these are all my tracks anyway. So, Facebook's cracking down on that kind of stuff. You know, it's smack people when they're down, you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
You know, because Facebook, you know, they're kind of, things are tough. Things are tight over at Facebook right now. So, Mark's kind of, you know, not being able to make his bins payment and stuff. So, what's next? Oh, yes.
Bailey.
You guys can probably hear Bailey walking through the wood floor. Pittery, pattery, pittery, pattery. All right, so this is a song that I have done a few times, handful of times on my lives, and You know, again, one of the tenor vocalists that I wanted to honor on this record was the great
Bailey.
I need names, I need a teleprompter, man. I just never can.
I can help you.
Don Henley, the great Don Henley. And this is one of my favorite tunes of his, man. It's just a, it's a dark story wrapped around beautiful music. It's and I was so fortunate to have the great and legendary Michael Omardian, legendary, successful producer, pianist, played on all that Steely Dan Asia stuff. Christopher Cross, he's a Christopher Cross, he's done. I mean, the list of people that he's produced goes on and on and on. And I was just, it was so fortunate to have him in the studio with me today, that day. And we stripped it down, you know, all that great production that's in this song. I wanted to do it stripped down, just piano vocal, and try to capture the essence of that song, because it's a brilliant song. So, we're going to do that right now. New York Minute, off of Origins by the great...
Don
Henley. Here we go. Take a drink of water first.
Water? He's got two cups over there.
All right. Here we go. That just
excellent.
That just tells you the impact of that song.
Did
it's
you like our
amazing
backup?
Song.
Yeah. Did you like our backup vocals?
I love the backup vocals. I got me some BGVs going on in there.
And it wasn't just me, everyone.
Yes, it was.
I don't sing.
That was awesome.
Thank you, Emil, for those comments there. All right. Amazing. Brad Williams in the house. Good to see you guys.
He does that one so good. It's crazy. I get chicken skin every day.
So good to see you guys. Yeah. Let's see who's over here on YouTube. Logan Allen. Good to see you, man. Thank you for that. Andre is here. Tim Liberty. Liberty. With a V. Liberty. Oh, man. Good to see you guys. DT. He's watching from Tennessee. All right. Good to see you guys. Thanks for tuning in on over there on YouTube. Nada Smith is here. Awesome. Moonlight View is here. I love some of the YouTube names. They're like boat names, right? Moonlight View. It's like a boat name. Cool. All right, so. You guys having a good time this evening so far on the Songs from Origins live stream?
Yes, we are.
We are having a good time here. Again, I would like to say thank you very much to each and every one of you guys for tuning in tonight and watching this. This is a therapy for me to do this because I can't go and play live. So I play for you guys once a week. It's therapy for me. So thank you for tuning in. And thank you for guys for coming to hang on up this evening.
Our pleasure.
Cheers to each and every one of you.
Love you,
Cheers.
Buddy.
Some more people. I hit that tip jar. Patrick DeVille. Thank you very much. Tips are never expected, but always appreciated, all right? Eric says, you have...
Oh, no.
He says I have a booger on my nose.
Do I?
He made me write it.
Do I have...
If I do, it's in high def right now. All over the internet, baby. I'm going to sell that booger for later on.
Hey, with every coffee filter.
Man, you guys should be here on this party. We're having a party here tonight. And the alcohol has been flowing, I must say. You know, but this is what rock and roll is supposed to be about. It's a party. Rock and roll is a party, and that's what we're having tonight, right now.
Hey,
we're having a party, so thanks for tuning in.
Everything.
We need a party because, damn, it's getting crazy out there, people. All right.
I love you, buddy.
All right, that's twice you said you love him.
I do.
I love you, man.
I love you.
Okay. All right, so the next artist that I'm going to feature here tonight that I put on the record is one of my all-time favorite artists. The guy's like my hero. He's like my one of my vocal heroes. Hey.
What you need?
Roadie guy.
Right.
Water. Oops. Some water, please.
Water.
And be quick about it! I have watched this artist from the earliest inceptions of a band called Police. Loved the Police. Me and my friends could not get enough of the Police. And then when he went solo, just continued to amaze us all with his vocals, his songwriting, his craftsmanship, his storytelling. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it, man. Where's that finger, Ben?
You know exactly where it's
been. I'm trying to be serious here.
Okay.
It's not happening.
Never take yourself too seriously.
Oh, my gosh, no.
Anyway, Sting.
Oh, yeah. Back to
he's Sting. Like, Sting's like my musical hero, and I had to put some Sting music on here, but, you know, what song do you choose? My God, there's so much. Do I do a Police song? Do I do an up-tempo? Do I do one of his solo songs? And then, last year, he came out with a new record, Sting, My Songs. And he had like 14 tracks. He went in and recut a bunch of his hits and Police songs, most of which I had on my list of songs to put on this record. So I was like, okay, what am I going to do now? You know, so I, we were listening through videos and my wife says, oh yeah, you remember this song? And I just, I've forgotten about this song. This is like a hidden gem of his. And it's just, it's really a beautiful, masterfully done mid-tempo song. Sting at his best, really. And so I had to put it on the record. And so I'm going to play it for you right now. And again, Rex Schnelly, I have to commend him for the amazing job that he did on the song, recreating. And we did some things a little differently. We treated some things more acoustically, which we did on several of the tracks on this record. So, but right now, I'm going to play for you When We Dance by Sting.
And Rex is watching. Rex is on.
Still be still, 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 still.
settle down. He won't run like I've known. He won't give me this way. Hell, it's true to if you'll stay. Come and live with me. We'll
How we doing out there?
All good here.
I didn't hear a word.
How are you guys doing in here?
We are good.
Happy Tiny Friday.
That's right.
Friday.
Oh, yeah.
Tiny Friday. Okay.
Happy Friday Eve.
Yeah, Friday Eve. There you go.
Okay. So.
Silver button on your underwear.
That's so funny.
They say my kids all the time. I don't know why.
Alright, so.
Oh, button on your underwear.
You, again, you can't have a tenor rock vocal tribute album without putting the amazing Lou Graham on a record. What a voice, man. God. One of the most amazing rock voices that we've ever heard. Damn, you know, I just loved Foreigner. So, I had to put a Foreigner song on this record. And again, that was a hard choice, too. Way back in the day, Rudy and Cindy to George, thank you very much for hitting that tip jar. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Again, the tip jar, tips are not mandatory, never, but always very appreciated. The live links to it, a couple of the tip jars are at the top of this feed on Facebook. They're also at the top of the feed on YouTube. So, anything you feel like contributing, thank you very much. It's very much appreciated. Not required, but much appreciated. So, again, this was a hard choice to narrow down. Back in the day when I was in a cover band called ISIS, completely different meaning. ISIS is actually the Egyptian goddess of fertility. Boy, did they twist that one around. So I settled on this tune because it's just one of those iconic vocal lines. When you hear it, it's just so embedded in your head from the 80s. That when you hear that chorus come, you just know it. And that's why I wanted to do this song. And we really wanted to take a different angle on this one, especially on the intro of the song. So the whole first verse of an intro of a song is just acoustic. It's real mellow. It kind of creeps into the vibe of the song, and then bam, it hits. So I really loved how this turned out. Again, kudos to my man Rex Schnelli. You know, we talked about the production on this one and talking about doing this a little different take on this in the beginning of the song. And we took away pretty much all throughout this record. There's tunes, a lot of tunes from the 80s, some tunes from the 70s. Again, this was the era that inspired me. So when I was a kid, a younger young man. But we wanted to get away from a lot of those keyboard sounds that were happening in the 80s. You know, as much as we all love them, they're not happening now. So we really did a good job on using different instrumentations to kind of color those sounds. This song is a perfect example of that woo, 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 big keyboard thing. That's guitar, that's Rex on guitar, and we affected it a little bit. So everything is, like even in the intro of the Journey song, track one on the record, that's all big, you know, Jonathan Cain keyboards, but we used cellos. We multi-tracked the cello part, the keyboard parts, because we didn't want to use heavy keyboards on this record. So, just giving you a little insight on the production angle for this record. But this song right here, one of my all-time favorite Foreigner songs, Waiting for a Girl Like You. Here we go.
So long, I've been looking too hard, I've been waiting too long. Sometimes I don't know what I will find. I only know it's a matter of time when you love someone. When you love someone. Feels so right, so warm and true. I need to know if you feel it too. Baby, I'm wrong. Won't you tell me if I'm coming on too strong? It's hard to mind as I've heard before, but this time I want to be sure. I've been waiting for a guy like you to come into my life. I've been waiting for a guy like you to love that will survive. I've been waiting for someone to make me feel alive. Yeah. Thank you.
Such a great song. Such a great song.
I think that's one of my favorites.
Yeah, Rex did an amazing job on that one right there. All right. So why are you covering that up?
I have
some other kind of derogatory comment going on there. All right, so more people have graciously hit that tip jar. So very big thanks to Emily Rushing, Susan, David, and Logan Allen. Thank you very much. And Jan Diebert. Thank you guys for hitting that tip jar so much. Michael Bailey, appreciate that. For hitting that tip jar. You guys rock, man. Eric stole some tips from the tip jar.
Hey, Jeff.
Yes.
Rex is watching.
Rex is watching. Rex Schnelli is watching us this evening. What's up, my man?
He said that track was so much fun to build, man. Oh. You killed it.
Ah,
just
cool.
Share that.
Rex, I don't know if you heard that. Rex said that track was so much fun to build, man. You killed it. You killed it, man. No, you killed it, man. I love you, man. Okay. No, really. I mean, when like I said before I played the song, we talked about, you know, taking this in a different direction at the beginning of the song, building into it, and getting away from those big synthy keyboard things. Man, when he presented this track to me, I was like, oh my God, that's like, this is gonna be killer, man. So it turned out great. So Rex, you rock, man, you're the man. I'm looking forward to doing some more stuff together, man. So Rex is gonna be working with me on this next record. Got some new tunes. My next record is going to be an all original record, which I'm really excited about. I got some great songs happening right now in the works. I've got some collaborations that are really exciting to talk about, but I can't talk about them yet. You're just gonna have to wait. So anyway, all things good, man, all things good. So, let me see what's going on here. Let me see, I have some people on Facebook. There's Rex, I see him. Woo-hoo. Sharon Roberts, what's going on? She says, I was supposed to see Chicago and Don Felder this year. They moved to next year too. Yep, everybody's pretty much moving stuff. I think they're trying to scramble a few shows that may happen towards the end of the year, but I just don't know. You know, you just never know. But here in Florida, you guys have probably seen the news. We have moved into the reopening stage 3. So, I mean, I guess what that means is restaurants can operate at full occupancy inside. I think they're going to be opening up some bars and some small venues, but at limited capacity. So, you know, it's kind of moving towards reopening, which is a good thing in my opinion. So, a lot of people have different opinions. I think the sooner the better. So, good to see you guys, man. LP Mollison. Jill Best, how you doing? How you doing, Dieter, over there in Germany? How's it going? I believe it's early in the morning there in Germany. He's always up. He's always watching, man. You rock for that. All right. Moonlight View there on, there's that cool boat name. Moonlight View is watching on YouTube. All right, so we're going to move right along here to the next song. And this is a song that I wanted to do as a duet. So I did it as a duet. But I wanted to have an upbeat rockin' tune that could have a lot of fun with. And I always remembered this great track, you know. Tina Turner and Brian Adams. It was a Brian Adams song, and he played this as Tina Turner's accompaniment, and God, so good. And it's a song called It's Only Love. It's a rocker. Four chord rock and roll in your face. Excuse me.
Jack, honey. help with the tickle.
Dry throat tonight.
I might have to take a little sip of Jack, honey here to warm you up.
I thought that was water.
It is water.
Oh, okay.
I'm just preparing the Jack, honey.
Oh, okay. Just check it.
Got the IV ready.
Wash it down with a little Jack Honey. Cheers, everybody. Cheers to you guys.
Cheers.
Cheers, cheers. We're having our party on Thursday night.
It's 11:06 in Sydney on Friday.
Somebody watching from Sydney? Yes. Sydney, Australia, 11:06.
11:06 a.m.
Yeah, in the morning. Wow, they're getting their rock and roll on early in the morning. So, all right. So yes, I wanted to do this as a duet, and I had the great privilege of having a really amazing singer from Nashville, Miss Peyton Taylor. She came on and sang the Tina Turner part. She killed it, and it turned out great. Again, this is another one of those Rex Schinelli tracks, man. He built it all up. So we're gonna rock and roll right here with a little It's Only Love. Here we go.
Let me get my volume right.
Make it up. So, what? Four chord rock and roll, man. I mean, just rock and roll for your face right there. All right, so. Okay, we got some more people who have hit the tip jar.
I'm sorry, it's crooked. I'm a little crooked.
Vincent Blondo and Jeff Bailey. Thank you guys, really. Thank you for hitting that tip jar. Appreciate it. That's awesome. It's funding this next record, man. Appreciate everything. So, so I'm gonna do another artist here. This is a guy. You know, a lot of people, you know, probably may or may not have known his name, but he had some hits in the '90s. And brilliant songwriter, vocalist, now a brilliant producer. Jude Cole. Some of you know who Jude Cole is, some of you may not, but everyone should know who Jude Cole is because the guy's amazing. And so I wanted to do a song of his on here called Baby It's Tonight. You guys remember that? That's on the record, that's on Origins, and you can grab your copy right now if you don't already have one. Just go to my website, jeffcoffey.com. And you can get a digital download of it, or you can click the image at the front page and it takes you to the store where you can get a copy, physical copy. You can get a signed copy. We got all kinds of stuff on there too. I got t-shirts, I got koozies.
And coffee filters.
I mean, what better way to keep your drink cold than with a Jeff Coffee koozie? I mean, come on. We got coffee filters, I mean, masks. We got all kinds of goodies. So, I got a special going on Mask right now. 2 for $20. Check it out. Ship leave tomorrow. Sail over tomorrow.
1 for $10, 2 for $20. That's a
sale. All right. So, we're going to do Baby It's Tonight off of Origins right here. Here we go. This is, I love this tune. This is going to be fun. Here we go. You ready, Rex? Here we go, man. Ready to play, Rex? You pick up the phone, 'cause I know that you're home. Many words have not been said for us to be living alone. Not all of the fire, all of the tears, well, they don't matter now. Another night falls, dark and lonely. You're the only one that I can turn to. If I ever need a job, baby, it's still night. And if I ever need to just be you, baby, it's still night. So come me close, show me that you still care. Speak it to where it all began and start again from there. 'Cause there's no way I can tell. I'm walking in a world, stranger. You're the only one who really knows me. If I ever need a child to hold me, baby, it's tonight. If I ever need a child to give me, baby, it's tonight. Oh, oh, won't you please, please pick up the phone, yeah. Ooh. Don't leave me the places where I if I ever need a chance to heal me, baby, it's tonight. If I ever need Some more people have hit that tip jar. Barack Tubinsi. Tubinsi. Thank you for hitting that tip jar. Becky Schuler and Scott Green. Thank you guys so very much. Appreciate that. It's awesome of you guys to do that. Thank you. So, the next tune here, this was so much fun, okay? Again, you know, when you think about the tenor vocalist out there that you... You know, if you're going to do a tribute record, who do you want to pay homage to? And one of my all-time favorite vocalists out there is Kenny Loggins. I mean, you know, I just grew up with Kenny's voice, man. And and this one tune in particular, I've always I mean, there's so much of his music from the 70s stuff to the 80s stuff. I love Kenny Loggins. I love his songwriting, I love his voice, and this tune in particular was one that the groove of the song was so infectious, and that's why I picked this one. Again, it's like, which song do you do of his, from which era? And but I said, no, you know, I always, every time it comes on, and I turn it up, I love this tune, and it's a song called This Is It, and he co-wrote this one with Michael McDonald. I believe he co-wrote this one, yeah. And because you hear Michael McDonald's vocals on this one too, not on my record. We tried to kind of, you know, emulate the Michael Bolt and the Michael. Michael McDonald thing, but but you know, just a great song. And how fortunate for me, I know the drummer that recorded the song. Had the great fortune, the great privilege. Wow. I'm making up words now.
Sure, that's pleasure.
What did you put in this water, man?
That's pleasure.
I swear the finger did not go into water.
That's pleasure and privilege. That's privilege.
Privilege.
I mean, I get it. The great distinct pleasure and distinct privilege and distinct honor of not only getting to play music live with this man, but getting to know him as a person. Hanging with him, and while I was in Chicago, I'm talking about the great Tristan Bowden. What a great illustrious career he has had, played with so many of my favorite artists, Kenny Loggins being one of them, Al Jarreau being another one, so many people, and I had the great fortune to play with him while I was in Chicago. And I thought, hey man, if I'm gonna do this song, God, would that be awesome if I had Tris come and play on it? Because he recorded this track originally with Kenny about 40 years ago. Well, 41 years ago now. And so, picture if you will, I'm in the studio and I've got Tris and Bowden on drums. I'm at the beautiful Mike Latanzi studio, Latitude South in Nashville. Beautiful, beautiful studio. If you want to do a record, call Mike Latanzi. It's a beautiful place. You will not want to leave. I was so excited about this day because I made all these preparations. You know, had Tris come in from LA. So I'm sitting there in the studio here, and this is a weird kind of cross-pollinization of people who have worked with who. I got Tris Bowden on drums, who played with Kenny Loggins on this original track, played with me in Chicago. I've got Chris Rodriguez on guitar, who Chris has had an amazing career himself, played with so many big artists, Keith Urban, Kenny Loggins, you know, you name it, so many people. And so he's played this song with Kenny many times. Then I have the amazing, incredible Michael Omardian on piano over here, who has produced so many artists, but he's produced people that Chris has played with, you know. He's produced Peter's Terra, you know. Christopher Cross. God, I guess it just goes on and on. I mean, I could go on and on, but...
You're having a brain fart.
I am having a brain fart. I'm thinking about this song. I need my fact sheet with me. I've got this incredible ensemble of musicians in the studio. I'm looking around going, my God, what an awesome band this would be. But I knew the tracks were going to be amazing. I mean, I think we did maybe three takes. We had it in take two, you know, and when you see Michael Omardian bouncing around the studio during playback, you know you got it. And so that was the vibe of that day in the studio, and we captured it on the video that's on YouTube. And so much fun, so much fun. So I'm going to set the volume on this. So this is myself on bass, Chris Rodriguez on guitar, Tristan Bowden on drums, Michael Omardian on piano, and then Rex came in, took the tracks, and then he added some things and some V3 and added some textures. Turned out great, and some background vocals he also added. So it's a song called This Is It. Here we go. This is going to be a lot of fun. If only I had them here right now to play this for you guys.
That would be amazing.
Our husband in a room.
That's okay.
There's been times in my life I've been wondering why. Still, somehow I believe you'll always survive. Now I'm not so sure you're winning yet. One good reason to try. Lord, what more can I say? Slept to come by. You think that maybe it's over. Only if you want it to be. Your miracle, stand up and fight. This is it. Make no mistake, we are back to the corner. This is it. Don't be a fool anymore. Waiting is over. No, don't you run. No matter how. Time for wondering why. Here, the moment is now. About to decide. Let him believe. Leave him behind. Keep me here in your heart. No, whatever you do, here by your side. Not up to me this time.
Studio, my God.
And that's another first one that you've done, right?
That's right. I have not done that one on these lives yet. You know, that one is so percussive and so groovy, it's kind of hard to get into it, just acoustic
moosey.
Guitar.
It's moosey.
It's moosey. That's right. It's very moosey. Just feeling all moosey inside, just talking about it. People are just tuning in going, what the hell are they talking about? You should have been here earlier. Watch the playback. We're talking about Moosey.
You're right.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, man, this has been so much fun. I got one more song for you guys, man. And, again, you know, you think about the artist who you can, you know, do on a, put on a tribute record. And undoubtedly one of the most influential artists from one of the most influential bands on the planet. Sir Paul McCartney, and this is one of his great tunes from Paul McCartney and Wings. Man, I love that band. I remember listening to that band on the radio when I was a kid all the time. So many great songs would come on the radio. So many great melodies, you know, and that's Paul McCartney. But before I play this last one, I just want to say again, a huge thank you to each and every one of you guys for tuning in from all over the country. Different parts of the world to hang out with me for this hour and a half and just kind of take a stroll through Origins, this tribute record that I did last December, and just honoring and paying homage to all those great vocalists that inspired me when I was a kid and fired me up to kind of want to be a musician. I blame all of them. It's their fault.
Thank God.
Right. You should not have gone in the music business, kid.
What were you thinking? But you're too talented not to.
All right. You know, I tried something else for a few years.
Irrigation.
And before I got the Chicago gig, I stopped playing music for about 3.5-4 years. Just burnt, you know. And I tried something else. But that's when you really realize there is nothing else that I can do, you know? I mean, not just saying that as in a comical way, but just I have to play music because I will go absolutely insane, batshit crazy if I don't play music. And so I have to, you know? And every musician that does it for a living out there, they'll tell you the same thing. We don't do this just because we love it. We do it because we have to, because it's just what makes us get up in the morning, you know what I mean? So that's
what
I'm doing.
It's your kids that get
me. It's my damn kids that get me up now. All right, I'm gonna leave you guys with this last song here. It's a song called "Maybe I'm Amazed" by Paul McCartney and the Wings. Thank you guys for tuning in tonight. All right, appreciate it. Here we go.
All right, let me get my volume right here. All right, ready, band?
Ready. BGBs.
Here you go. Baby, I'm amazed at the way you love me all the time. Baby, I'm afraid of the way I love you. Hold me up tight. You hold me alive. This was a blast to do these songs, a lot of songs that I haven't done before in my life, and to play along with the tracks, it just fires me up even more to get out there with the band. So I wish you guys an awesome rest of your Thursday evening, and happy weekend to you coming up, and we'll see you guys real soon. Probably going to take next week off, do some more writing, and so we'll see you guys very soon, okay? Peace.
How do you end it?
Oh my god, how do you end it?
You have to turn the phone off, isn't it?